Hello everyone, I'm Vikram P. Madhur here, and in this session we're going to discuss about a couple of latest topics that we have in PWA 7.5 Service Pack 4. So we have been discussing a couple of latest innovations and additions to the SAP PWA 7.5 Service Pack 4 and Service Pack 7 as well. So in this, this is the third session I'm creating on the PWA 7.5 Service Pack 4 enhancements. So we have new enhanced technical content. So data volume information to monitor the size of PWA objects is being done. So what we exactly have with this is, like, you know, you can actually check the data volume information. And I mean, like, basically with that, we can understand the size of the business PWA objects. And request overview of advanced data store objects based on CDS views, CDS technology for easier and simplified operations. We have installation, loading, and activation is not required. Real-time access can be had. So enhancements in open ODS views. We have new open ODS views creation wizard. Previously we had it in normally we had to go to the modeling pod. So now here we have a separate creation wizard for open ODS views. Then we have navigational attributes from associated virtual info objects. So what we can do with this feature is, like, we have let's say we have a attribute of one character can be associated with another character. That's what actually we can do. You know, linking up the navigation attribute of one character to other. So SAP HANA multi-tenant database container MDC support BW 7.5 Service Pack 5 BWMT 1.15. So for these more of features of this, you can check out the SAP note, which you can see on the screen. So central maintenance of BW hierarchies via Webdynamo. Enhanced feature support of HANA view generation. Push down from OLAP to SAP HANA for formulas with exception aggregation, variable with replacement path, additional exception aggregations, and dynamic selections is what we can have. We have in push down from OLAP to SAP HANA system. So we have SAP HANA based extraction, support of DDP extraction from advanced DSO to including archive NLS. So SAP HANA performance in improvements in data transfer process, extraction of very large data volumes with HANA processing. So basically here we have a new feature where we can have this DDP supporting the extraction from advanced DSO to other info providers. So the roadmap is one of the most important thing that we have here. So basically today what we have and what are the capabilities that we have in the future and what is planned and what will be in the future. So we have today, we have integration with SAP HANA platform, leverage SAP HANA smart data integration, further push down of data intensive functions, user experience. So based on the integration with SAP HANA platform, we have these two, like leverage SAP HANA smart data integration, and we have further push down of data intensive functions. On the user experience perspective, we have Eclipse based modeling for advanced DSOs, composite providers, query designers, info objects, open hub, info source, etc. Simplification, we are doing the simplification. We have enhanced advanced DSO features, planning, support, inventory handling, etc. Semantic groups for data flows in the advanced DSOs, big data scenarios, real-time streaming of BW objects, support of Hadoop as NLS, HANA extension nodes for warm data management. So we have discussed about the warm data management in detail when we're discussing of the big data scenarios. So we have exposing BW data models for SQL consumption. So enhanced featured support of HANA view generation, pruning support, enabling of hierarchies, etc. SAP BW/4 HANA starter add-on. So we have general availability plan for September 2016. This is what we have for it was way back in 2016. It was available. So the SAP BW/4 HANA starter add-on. Okay, so what are the planned innovations that we have is like integration with SAP HANA platform, a seamless transition into SAP HANA mixed scenarios, user experience, modern UI for data flow modeling, SAP UI5 based scheduling, monitoring and administration. Simplification would be on conversion tools for simple transition to SAP BW on HANA objects, enhanced integration with S4 HANA, integration with Amazon Web Services. This is AWS, AWS, popularly called as AWS. So run SAP BW in an AWS instance. So this is very much possible. Already there are couple of projects which are rolled out with AWS. So big data scenarios, highly automated data lifecycle management, the NLS Hadoop integration with the SAP HANA Vora. And then we have data access scenarios with Hadoop. So we have this SAP HANA Vora. So I'm going to talk more about the SAP HANA Vora, which is something which is, we should be knowing about that in the future. Okay, so future direction, what exactly would be the future direction for this SAP BW and HANA? So integration with SAP HANA platform, SAP HANA mixed scenarios as integral part of SAP BW, user experience all in modern UI, BW as a part of the SAP HANA data warehouse, common orchestration and scheduling, tight collaboration with SAP HANA data warehousing tools, and integration with SAP S4 HANA, smooth integration with SAP S4 HANA analytics, new content scenarios. So these are the things that we have on in the future direction. So this is about SAP HANA data warehousing strategy for the future. Now whatever is planned here, the planned innovations are already right now in place. This has been done, and even in the future directions, mostly it will be done very soon. So here we have two approaches. So data warehousing approaches. So we have application driven approach and SQL driven approach. In application driven approach, we have SAP BW as extended data warehousing, and then we have application with integrated services. So SAP BW as an application serves as a platform offering all required data warehousing services via one integrated repository. So no additional tools for modeling, monitoring and managing the data warehousing is required, but can be integrated. Now, SQL driven approach, that's SAP HANA with loosely coupled tools and platforms, services logically combined. So we have database approaches require several loosely coupled tools to fulfill the necessary tasks with separate repositories, and a combination of tools such as best of breed used to build the data warehousing technology. So we have in SAP HANA, we had SAP HANA separately, and we have the SAP BW, we had the scheduling and monitoring, we had the modeling, we have the planning, we have OLAP, we have life management, and we have ETL. So for everything, we have tools here in SAP HANA. We have tools for every aspect of SAP BW, whether it might be scheduling tool, modeling tool, planning tool, monitoring tool, life cycle management tool, and ETL tool. So we have a statement of direction, current data warehousing portfolio, and so the planning and definition in 2015, the analytics BI suit predictive. In this, we have the market presence in data warehousing with a clear roadmap was there in 2015. So we say we have SAP HANA platform, and it has been integrated with Hadoop, SAP HANA Vora. And then we have SAP HANA data warehousing. So we have DWH foundation, we have HANA EIM, we we have business warehousing, and we have power design. So all this would be integrated. Now in the in execution and delivery in 2016 to 18, a strong and simplified offering with tight integration has been done. So we have Power Designer, we have Business Warehouse, and Data Warehousing Foundation and HANA EIM together on a HANA platform. And we have the Hadoop also, Hadoop SAP HANA Vora also complementing it. And then in the future, it would be like a data warehousing modeling and data warehousing ETL and DM. Both would be completely on the SAP HANA platform. So the convergence into one technology stack addressing BW and SQL based data warehousing needs. So here, if you see, it was a separated or independent system, which is coming under a same platform in the future. And thanks for watching this session. Have a great day. Yeah, thank you.